Hello and welcome to After Dark Online with Crossy and Rall. With World Environment Day on the 5th of June, we'll be celebrating this aspect by covering the topic of sustainability here tonight. My name's Andrew, I'm the Environmental Approvals Director here at Crossy and Rall. So what am I going to cover? I'm going to talk a little bit first about what Crossy and Rall, then what sustainability is, talk through how this translates to rail projects, why we include sustainability principles, and what it means for Cross River Rail, and then going to hand over to the project sustainability manager to talk through what this actually looks like in practice on the ground. So what is Cross River Rail? Cross River Rail is a public transport infrastructure project in Brisbane that will be transforming the way we travel through southeast Queensland. It consists of 10.2 kilometres of new railway line, with 5.9 kilometres of twin tunnels that travel beneath the Brisbane CBD and Brisbane River, from which we'll then be building four new underground stations, upgrading eight additional stations along that 10.2 kilometres, and then implementing and installing a new world-class signalling system so we can run more trains on this new network and move more passengers through the system, and also building three new Gold Coast stations to take advantage of this capacity. So why do we need Cross River Rail? Well, at its heart, the rail network in Brisbane and in the CBD area is constrained in its core, with only one crossing of the Brisbane River for trains coming from the south and southern Bayside area. This includes the current passenger services through the City Train network and also passenger services from interstate from New South Wales and freight, constraining its core and limiting the number of trains and therefore passengers we can move through these stations in this area. So Cross River Rail will be unlocking and adding extra capacity to that network and providing future capacity to take the growth of southeast Queensland. Cross River Rail extends from the north side of Brisbane near Albion and Breakfast Creek, travelling south through the Exhibition Station area, and then traverses underground from the northern portal area near the inner city bypass, underneath Roma Street and Albert Street and the Brisbane River, underneath the Woolloongabba near the Gabba Stadium, and then emerges down near the Boggo Road and Dunham Park area on the southern side of Brisbane. We then have a range of stations from Fairfield through to Salisbury that we're upgrading in the rail network in that area, plus the three stations down the Gold Coast that I mentioned before. This will add extra capacity and future-proof the system so that we have more accessibility to the networks for passengers and customers, and also extra capacity on the network as the population grows in southeast Queensland. Throughout the last year, we've completed the main tunnelling and excavations on the project, and now we're getting into the station build to moving forward. So moving on from what Cross River Rail is, it's important to talk about and set the scene about what sustainability is. So first, when considering sustainability, we need to understand what are we trying to achieve and what does sustainability mean to me and also to the project for Cross River Rail. So let's look at first what sustainability is defined as and what it translates to in practice. At its core, sustainable development requires an integrated approach that takes into consideration environmental and social concerns along with economic development. In 1987, the United Nations Brundtland Commission defined sustainability as meeting the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. This, in practice, generally translates to ensuring that development and activities that happen today do not negatively affect the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. So how does this translate to infrastructure projects? Whilst we can't address the fundamental cultural aspects of sustainability in the wider society, we can address it on how it relates to our project. And we do this by adopting and applying sustainability aspects and principles throughout the life cycle of the project. And it underpins all aspects from the project approvals and their associated conditions that we need and management plans that we need to follow for the design, construction, operation of the project, to various sustainability policies and sustainable procurement policies about how we purchase different goods and items that we need to build and operate our project. From this, we integrate the principles of sustainability into all aspects of the project, helping deliver beneficial outcomes that it drives. And we look at ways of measuring this to see how we're traveling along this route and if we're meeting our objectives. So how do you measure if you're achieving it? Well, there's a range of different industry recognised accreditation schemes out there, some of which you may be familiar with through different office buildings and also public infrastructure and accommodations such as NABERS and Green Star. And then on Cross River Rail, we use the Infrastructure Sustainability Council IS rating scheme. These schemes set out a framework and approaches for measuring and rating the economic, social, and environmental performance of a project. And from this, we're able to assess its sustainability of performance, helping deliver buildings and infrastructure that have been planned, designed, and delivered to meet the needs of society while enhancing the environment and economy in which we're operating. So why do we do this? Well, it helps quantify and deliver these economic, social, and environmental opportunities and benefits for the project. And it sets us out across all phases of the project so that we can plan early and implement it across all facets successfully and effectively so we get the outcomes that we desire from it. It achieves this by helping integrate better design methods and approaches to our projects, considering sustainability aspects and also future adaption and climate change aspects where appropriate. We look for and adopt materials and equipment that are better for the environment and have less impact. It helps set up benchmarks and improve standards across different infrastructure projects, so we're continually moving forward and looking at new and better ways to do things with less impact. It helps reduce risks for projects, and it also fosters efficiency and waste reduction, innovation, and continuous improvement across the project by finding ways that are more efficient to do things, reducing waste and being more effective. And it also helps recognize the sustainability outcomes on a project, building a business and project's reputation. So at Cross River Rail, as outlined, there's a lot of sustainability principles that really help deliver a more effective project. And we recognize the importance of integrating sustainability outcomes into our project and the benefit delivers. It helps integrate these economic, social, and environmental considerations across the planning, design, and operation phases of the project and construction phases. And for our project, we're aiming to get an excellent rating for both our tunnel stations and development and rail integration system parts of the project. And we'll be doing this through the infrastructure sustainability rating scheme for the project. And it's helping drive a range of innovations that we're already seeing across the project. Now, over to Glenn Hedges, the project sustainability manager, to talk through some of these initiatives on the ground.
Thanks, Andrew, and thanks for the opportunity to talk about some of the things that we're doing on a practical level on the Cross River Rail project. So sustainability is just another way of doing things cheaper, faster, better, safer, and greener. And the things that I want to talk about are things how we're reducing our embodied carbon footprint for the project, as well as how we're adopting circular economy outcomes, i.e. using recycled materials on our project. One of the things that we're using on the Cross River Rail instead of natural river sands and quarry products is crushed recycled glass. Brisbane in the southeast corner uses about half of its recycled glass wastes and makes new bottles out of it. But what happens to the other half? Until recently, they went to landfill. We've now discovered and worked with a variety of people to reuse and recrush the glass to form an alternative quarry material that we're using as pipe embedment, we're using it as bedding sand, we're using it as free draining granular material behind retaining walls, and a variety of other instances across the project. And that's with the blessing of Queensland Rail, Brisbane City Council, and Transport and Main Roads. Another exciting thing that we're trialling on Cross River Rail is instead of using concrete railway sleepers, we're going to try plastic or composite plastic sleepers. We've got two examples here shown on the screen, and they're going to be used at our main yard to trial the loads and over a period of time confirm that they are fit for purpose as an alternative to concrete sleepers. Another example of using recycled materials is instead of using steel reinforcement or steel mesh in pavements, we're using a recycled macro fiber called e-mesh. You can see the size here, they're 5 centimeters long, and we use them in our raw concrete mixes to make driver pathways and other footpaths around the project. They're durable, they have high strength, they're fit for purpose, and we don't need as much steel, or we can take out all the steel in these driver pavements and footpaths going forwards. So that's another example of using recycled materials and lower carbon materials as well. Talking of concrete, the Cross River Rail project is also using a lot of waste materials as a cement alternative in its concrete. We're using a lot of fly ash, and are using a lot of slag as an alternative to cement, sometimes in mixes up to 60% instead of cement. This has a huge contribution to reducing the project's embodied energy and carbon footprint. And as you can imagine, we use a lot on Cross River Rail of concrete. Another example of using a recycled material instead of more higher carbon materials such as concrete and steel is in all of our trackside pits and cable troughs throughout the entire alignment, all the way from Albion down to Salisbury. Some of the examples that you can see here are recycled plastic pits using HDPE, so that's made out of your recycled milk bottles and orange juice containers and things like that. These materials, or the plastics that are used to create these pits and troughs, have been tried and tested, found to be just as durable, if not better than concrete, far more adaptable, and again, have a far reduced carbon footprint and using a lot of waste materials that would otherwise go to landfill. But we're not just using materials that we're creating. What do we do with all the spoil that comes from Cross River Rail? We've found a very unique partnership with Austral Bricks over at Rocklea, and thousands of tons of our spoil from our tunnels and stations is going to be made into bricks over the coming 7 years. We think 120 million bricks can be made over the coming 7 years with all the spoil coming out of Cross River Rail. That's pretty sustainable. We're also using a variety of other recycled quarry products on our project. You can't just use any old bits of soil or fill in some of our project areas. You need to have compaction rates, you need to have them of a certain moisture content and strength. So what we've tried to do is use and tweak the soils that we're producing on our site to reuse them on our site as road base, pavements, and as fill materials in our structures. And that's, again, an alternative to either going to landfill or going to other sources well out of the city centre. That's a few examples of the recycled materials that we're using on Cross River Rail to help make a more sustainable outcome for the project and to lower the project's carbon footprint. Thank you.